Sum chơi những cuộc chơi.
The President, the court is now in session. We're going to hear further testimony from Prak Khan before we give the floor to the prosecutors. The chamber would like the greffier to verify the attendance of the parties and person concerned in today's session. The greffier, Mr. President, the parties to the proceedings today are all present. Witness Prak Khan is here in the courtroom, and witness KW11 is also present and awaiting someone from the court. The latter witness has no relation to the accused or to the civil parties, and he has already taken an oath. The President, next, we would like to give the floor to the co-prosecutors to put questions to this witness. The floor is yours. The President, the counsel for the witness, we note you on your feet. Mr. Kung Sum On, thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
I would like to raise few comments concerning the questionings put to the witness by Judge Lavenge yesterday, and later on the witness seemed to be mixed up, and I would like to point out these matters again so that Judge Lavenge could seek further clarification from the witness. There are two issues. First, regarding the documents concerning the testimony given to the co-investigating judges, and that document was not presented to the witness to prove that he did make such testimony. And the witness showed his position already in the morning when asked by Judge Yasakon concerning the cell incrimination matter, and the witness exercised his right not to respond to any such question. And later on, after he was asked by the Judge Lavenge regarding the testimony before the co-investigating judges, the witness responded, although he was not quite sure whether the activities as mentioned in the questions before the co-investigating judges related to the activities he committed personally, or was the activity committed on the orders of his superior. That's why, if the President allows, I think this witness should be asked again by Judge Lavenge to clarify whether he committed the tortures by himself spontaneously, of course, or upon the orders from his superior. Thank you.
Voilà qui compléterait la question posée par le juge Lavergne. Merci.
President, before we respond to your observation in the name of the president of the trial chamber of the extraordinary chambers in the courts of Cambodia once again remind Mr. Prak
Khan,
in the name of the witness, you can reject to respond to any questions that you are afraid that your testimony could self-incriminate you. Number two, as a witness, you have the duty to talk only about the truth. Something you witnessed, you have known. And yesterday, the hearing of the testimony regarding that particular section came to an end. And yet, this morning, such a testimony was challenged by a lawyer, your counsel. So you are reminded again that, Mr. Witness, that if you feel any response would or could self-incriminate you, then you should immediately consult your counsel before you could respond to such questions. And the defense, or the counsel, correction, should also be quick enough to consult your client when you note that any response to such question would put your client at risk of self-incrimination. And it is not appropriate to raise this matter after the session regarding that particular matter already passed. And if this practice repeats itself, it makes the chamber find it difficult to proceed expeditiously. So please be mindful of this matter.
Donc à vous souvenir de cela.
The President, after having taken into account the comments raised by the counsel for the witness and having discussed with the judges of the bench, the request is rejected.
Nous rejetons la demande de l'avocat.
So we are not going to go back to what happened yesterday as suggested by the counsel. And as I already mentioned, from now on, what we are mindful of is to make sure that the proceedings can move more expeditiously. And now I would like to give the floor to the co-prosecutor.
Et je voudrais sans plus attendre de la parole au co-procureur.
Co-prosecutor, Mr. President,
Monsieur le Président,
Your Honors,
Madame, Messieurs les Juges, bonjour.
Mr. Prak Khan, good morning.
Monsieur Prak Khan, bonjour.
Yesterday you stated about the security regulations, you explained that these regulations were seen in all sections in the S21. Now, can you tell us who wrote such regulations and when were they written?
Et quand?
And to the best of your recollection, when did you first see these regulations? Did you see them when you first started work at S21, or did you come to know these regulations during any particular study session? Prakon. We were instructed on these security regulations during study sessions, and they were written and put in every room, and I don't remember when we were instructed or told about these rules and regulations, but as usual, interrogators should have a record of such rules and regulations in their notebook, and at their living room, they would put a sticky note regarding these regulations.
Prosecutor,
thank you. Who actually wrote those regulations, the regulations we saw yesterday on the screen?
Et qui sont apparus à l'écran.
Réponse. I don't know who wrote them.
Je ne sais pas qui les a rédigés.
Because everyone could write it, so I have no idea who would be the author of the writing.
Qui est l'auteur de ce texte?
Prosecutor, when you started working at S21 in 1976, did you see their rules and regulations already?
Déjà vu ces règles?
Response. At the beginning, I had not seen those rules. I came to know it at a later date.
J'en ai connaissance plus tard.
Prosecutor, thank you. Yesterday, question. You have spoken of a child who was dropped from the upper floor of the building. With the president's leave, may I ask that the building, the compound of the S21 be put on display again so that the witness can show the court from which building in particular the child was dropped.
ERN lịch sôn sôn đọc bấy ca sắp rằm mùi.
Document 00-1891-37.
Again, ERN 00-18-91-37. Say the president, the AV unit is advised to put it on the screen.
Je demande au service audiovisuel d'afficher cette page à l'écran.
Prosecutor, this is the map of the genocidal museum. So, Mr. Prakhan, can you please point to the picture from which building was the child dropped?
De quel bâtiment il s'agissait?
Con. These buildings were not the building I saw the child was being dropped. I saw the child was being dropped from another building which is outside of the compound next to the firefighter department, and there was a three-story building there. And when the detainees were brought in, they would be kept and walked to the last floor of that building. And Dyke Boo tried to wrest the baby from his mother, and he was carrying the baby, and when the mother was kept and locked inside the room, Dyke Boo dropped him from the floor. He was standing, and I was on the ground floor outside of the building, so I could see the child being dropped, and I was signaled by Boo to remove the baby, and I noted that he died, so I had him buried next to the
theater.
Prosecutor, thank you. Have you also noticed any killings of other children instead of this one child?
À l'exécution d'enfants, autre le cas de ce nourrisson?
Response, no, I had not seen any other killing of children. The President, the AV unit is instructed to turn to the normal view. Mr. Co-Prosecutor, Mr. President, I would like to apologize, but I would like to have the picture or the photo put on the screen again because I need to talk something about the photo. The President, the AV unit is instructed to put it back. Co-Prosecutor, yesterday you talked about the detention of a foreigner or foreigners. So in which building, if you can see in this photo, were the foreigners detained? Response. At the staircase, I noted that the foreigners were detained at building C.
Des étrangers étaient enfermés
co-prosecutor, on which floor, on which floor
question,
were
quel étage?
They detained? Response, the first floor.
Au premier étage.
Prosecutor,
question.
Thank you.
Merci.
Next question. May the AV unit be instructed to turn the screen to the normal view with the President's leave. Prosecutor, you were the interrogator at
S21.
When detainees were being walked to be interrogated, what would be your impression concerning the physical condition of each detainee being walked to be interrogated? Response. What would your question be? Are you asking about the general detainees or any particular detainee? Prosecutor. The question is rather referring to general detainees and also the detainee you walked to be interrogated. Response, I had not seen all the detainees because I was on guard outside, and the doors or the windows were closed. But I saw detainees who were, after their interrogation, sustaining some wounds on their body or backs. Because after they were sent to the chewing group, they would be beaten. Prosecutor, thank you. The next question.
Merci,
with the President's leave, I would like
si le président le veut bien.
Document with under ERN 0018-1437B put on this place, please. The president at the AV unit is advised to put this document 0018-1437 on the screen.
Veuillez afficher la page 0014-1437.
Prosecutor, you, if you look at this picture, is you are pointing to the instruments of torture.
Des instruments de torture.
Can you please,
est-ce que vous pourriez,
once again, tell the court what
à la cour,
were the equipment seen in the photo from your best recollection?
Que l'on peut voir sur cette photo. Pourtant, vous en souveniez.
Response.
Réponse.
At that time, I was pointing to the equipment. Actually, they were not the equipment or instruments used to beat the detainees. If these kind of tools were used to beat them, they would have died. None could survive.
Utilisés pour frapper les prisonniers, parce que si vous avez utilisé les
prosecutor, thank you. Next question. With the chamber's leave, may I ask that another photo under ERN 0018-9137 and next 48/1/8 be put on display. The president, the AV unit is instructed to put document with ERN 0018-9137 be put on the screen.
Document D45/1/8.
Prosecutor, this is an aerial photograph.
Question. Il s'agit ici d'une vue aérienne.
About the museum. So
du
you
musée.
Can see these buildings.
Et vous pouvez y voir
buildings A, B,
le bâtiment A, le bâtiment B,
C,
le bâtiment
and
C,
D.
Ainsi que le bâtiment D.
And in the compound, you can see some buildings lying right from the front gate. Having looked at this photo, can you tell the court
près de, du portail d'entrée,
in which section
dire,
would
chambre,
the detainees be put before they send to each respective building?
Arriver avant d'être répartis dans les différents bâtiments.
Response. Should I also point
the
path or the road to that location?
Le chemin qu'il suivait.
The prosecutor, if you can, please do so.
Le procureur, oui, si vous le pouvez.
Response.
Réponse.
Having a look at the photo, I can tell you that this is the place where detainees would have been walked from. So
les détenus arrivaient d'abord ici.
This is the sewage canal.
Près du canal.
The president, Mr. Co-prosecutor, how could you ask the witness to explain the photo by way of understanding himself alone? And what about the parties to the proceeding? We seem to have problem understanding how he can point from which direction to which, because we have no clue. Co-prosecutor, Mr. Prak, I would like now to tell you a little bit. If you look at the lower part of the photo, it is Road 350. And the first The first road, starting from that road, is road 310. And next to the building, there is another road, road 320.
Parallèlement, il y a la
Can you please tell the court in which, on which road, as I mentioned earlier, were you taking the detainees to S21?
À quel endroit vous
the president, we note lawyer Hong Kim-soon is on his feet.
Le président, Maître
Mr. Hong Kim-soon, I would like to apologize for interrupting the co-prosecutor. I think by way of explaining like that, I think it is still difficult to understand what we are talking about. Should there be any other approach instead? Prosecutor. With the president leave, it would be better if the photo be put on the projector. The president, you are allowed to do that.
Co-prosecutor, court officer, could you please give the witness a pen so that he can use it to indicate the locations on the map?
Afin qu'il puisse pointer les endroits pertinents sur la carte.
Prosecutor, let me restate.
Donc,
the street below is 350,
en bas,
and
la rue
the top part is the north, and
haut,
east is on your right,
nous avons le nord,
and west is on your left, and
droite,
below
est
is the south.
Gauche,
so the street adjacent to the compound is 350,
la rue
and next
348, ensuite on a
and in front is 330,
devant, on a la
and the street above adjacent
dessus,
to the compound is 320.
La 320 court,
can you tell us which street when you took the prisoners
Alors,
to be interrogated?
Vous emmeniez les prisonniers à l'interrogatoire par quelle rue?
Yes, I can indicate that.
Réponse, je peux vous l'indiquer.
On street 320, between the Douls line and the Zurich canal.
Entre donc le chenal.
So the location is around those houses, and they are all the interrogation
ici.
Houses.
Les maisons d'interrogation.
And along that
street,
there were also houses for interrogations. That is the location where
Ici,
I worked.
Moi, c'était là que je travaillais.
Question. Can you use the pen to circle the
Reprenez
location?
Prenez le stylo et pouvez-vous mettre un petit cercle?
Bracond. That is the location
voilà,
where
ici.
I worked at that
Moi,
time. It's on street
ici,
320.
Sur la 320.
And that
rue.
Location is in the middle between
Et
the Zurich canal
maison, donc, se trouvait à peu près
and
à
the main compound.
Entre le complexe principal et le chenal d'égout.
Let me say it again. On street 320, So from the entrance, 320. Going toward the east, and it's in the middle, voilà. Between the sewage canal and the compound, and the house was on the right side of the street. There is also another passage, with the house facing the east, and they are all interrogation houses. Thank you, says the co-prosecutor. Can you indicate the location where the blood was drawn from the prisoners, and also another location where a child was dropped from the upper floor? Or maybe the location is a little bit further at the bottom part of the sketch? Court officer, can you assist?
Plus vers le bas de cette carte.
Going a little bit further down, says the co-prosecutor. Yes, actually move the sketch to the bottom part. Please indicate the locations Donc, where the blood was drawn from the prisoners and where a child was dropped from the upper floor.
Prenez le sang des prisonniers et l'endroit où l'enfant a été précipité du dernier étage.
Yes, I can show the locations. That is the main entrance of the current tool slide, and a little bit toward that location, that is the medical office. So that was the location where the blood was drawn, yes.
Et c'est là que
and the location where a child was dropped.
Et l'endroit où un enfant
actually, there was a street coming from the north and from the Maypleung.
Il y avait une rue.
And at that junction, at that corner, voilà. That was the location.
Ce carrefour-là, c'est
because there is there was a small passage towards Toltompong at that junction. Thank you, says the co-prosecutor. I do not have more questions for you, and I would like to give the floor to my international co-prosecutor. The president, I noticed the presence of François Roux. You take the floor.
Le co-procureur international prenne la parole, mais Maître Roux a la parole, dit le président.
Oui. Monsieur le Président, pour les besoins du procès-verbal, je pense qu'il serait bon de mettre des lettres sur les points que vient d'indiquer le témoin, par exemple les lettres A, la lettre B et la lettre C. A étant le premier point qu'il a montré, là où il travaillait, B étant l'endroit où on prélevait le sang, selon ses dires,
according to what he's saying,
et C étant l'endroit où, toujours selon ses dires, il a vu la scène de l'enfant jeté. Et on pourrait alors garder ce document au dossier à disposition des parties, si la Chambre en est d'accord.
Le président.
The president. The chamber agrees to the request made by the
Nous
defense counsel
avec la
regarding
du de la
the locations, the three locations indicated
les trois
by the witness. They are
the témoin.
The office where he interrogated the prisoners that indicated by A,
qui serait indiqué par la
and B was for the location where the blood was being drawn from the prisoners,
and le sang des prisonniers étant l'endroit B,
another location which was to the west
C,
of the fire truck station,
vers l'ouest
and at the corner
de
to the east of Dulles Line towards the south.
Et au sud.
It is the location where the witness said
le
the child of a Vietnamese parents were dropped from the third floor.
De parents vietnamiens avaient été jetés du troisième étage.
Now the international court prosecutor can proceed with questioning.
Le procureur international, vous avez la parole.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honours. Good morning, Mr. Prak-Khan. I just have a few questions for you this morning. I'd like to follow up on a couple of matters that were raised yesterday. And firstly, I would like to ask you if you can look at document D32-4, ERN 0017-4392 in the Khmer, and English 0022-4127. And Mr. President, with your permission, can that document be shown by the AV, please?
The President, the AV officer, can you project the document as requested by the International Court Prosecutor?
Mr. Prak-Khan, this is one of the confessions in which you were involved in writing. Your signature appears as an interrogator within that document. I would ask you to look. This document is, in fact, Mr. President, 589 pages, and it's the confession of Heng, alias Chon. He was 32 years of age. He was chief of the power station. It's an S21 confession. If you look at the annotation that's in the box, it's in red, and perhaps if I just read it, it states, important, request the ministry should conduct a prompt examination in order to have the people completely removed from the ministry and to pave way for the possibility of taking the control of the Ministry of Commerce and others.
Mr.
Prak-Khan, this is a confession in which you were the interrogator from the names that appear on it throughout. Do you see the annotation on the screen, and can you tell the judges who you believe wrote that?
Nous dire à votre sens qui a écrit cette annotation.
Prak-Khan.
Réponse.
This is not my handwriting.
Ce n'est pas mon écriture.
I am not sure who annotated this confession in order for me to further interrogate the person.
Qui a écrit ceci?
Thank you.
En tout cas, cela me donnait l'ordre de poursuivre
l'interrogatoire. Is it possible that it's the accused Doik's handwriting?
Est-ce qu'il est possible que ce soit l'écriture de l'accusé? Est-ce que l'accusé utilisait toujours un stylo rouge?
Prak-Khan. It is
réponse.
Hard for me to identify because it is not clearly
de quelle écriture
written.
Il s'agit. Ce n'est pas très clair.
When I read that annotation out to you, I stated that it states that it was in order to have to conduct a prompt examination in order to have the people completely removed from the ministry and pave way for the possibility of taking the control of the Ministry of Commerce and others. As an interrogator S21, to you, what did that comment mean? What did that request mean?
Cela signifie quoi pour vous?
Prak-Khan, could you please repeat your question?
Pouvez-vous répéter votre question, s'il vous plaît?
On looking at the annotation, what was the person who wrote that annotation, what were they asking someone else to do?
La personne qui
what
a
did that annotation
ceci,
mean to you?
Demandez quoi? Elle vous donnait la mission de faire quoi? La personne qui avait annoté ceci à votre adresse.
This annotation means
cette annotation
I was required to further interrogate the prisoner.
Interroger le prisonnier plus avant.
And when it states
question.
To pave way for the possibility of taking control of the Ministry of Commerce, what do you think that meant?
ça, ça veut dire quoi, à votre sens?
Prakon, I really do not understand it.
Je ne comprends pas.
Thank you. I will follow up with the question that was asked by Judge Yasokhan yesterday.
And he asked some questions about
prisoners having their blood taken and subsequently dying. I'd like you to look at the following film clip. It's a film clip from Rithi Pan's documentary S21 Killing Machine, where you made a number of statements. And it's to the AV unit with your consent. Mr. President, it's clip 19, and it's D69 V0017-2620, and it starts at 1 hour and 8 minutes and 42 seconds to 1 hour and 10 minutes and 27 seconds. I would ask the AV unit, Mr. President, with your permission, that they start at the 25-second mark, and I would ask that it be shown, and I would ask to ask the witness a couple of questions about that. There's no protected witnesses on this video, Your Honour. It's a public
video.
The AV unit,
service audiovisuel.
Can you play the video clip on the monitor as requested by the international co-prosecutor?
Selon la demande du co-procureur.
They took the prisoners, they let them down on beds with metal springs, they changed their feet and their arms through either side of the bed. They were blindfolded and gagged, heads attached to the bed. Then they stuck a tube in each arm with pouches for the blood and they pumped it. I asked how many pouches they filled, and I was told four pouches per person. There was nothing left. Once the blood was taken, they were left against the wall. They breathed like crickets. Their eyes bulged. One night, they couldn't move. Prakon, just their eyes and their breathing. They couldn't feel anything. The pits were dark nearby. I could hear them, and we buried the corpses. One night, did that happen often? Prakon, they took blood depending on hospital demand. When the major hospitals needed blood, once every month or two, one night. Here are vouchers for taking blood. You said two or three persons only. That was only a small part. Take blood, all of them. Prakon, I saw about 20 people, one night, all of them, for blood.
Toutes ces personnes-là pour le sang.
Thank you, Mr. Prakon. That video clip or that filming was done at S21, is that correct?
Cette scène a été tournée à S21, n'est-ce pas?
Prakon, that is correct.
Oui, c'est correct.
And the vouchers for blood that Van Nutt showed you, had you seen them before when you were working at S21?
Ces bordereaux lorsque vous étiez à S21, lorsque vous y travailliez?
Van Nutt, the
réponse.
Vouchers for blood.
Ces bordereaux.
Remains until today, and that is true.
Sont toujours là aujourd'hui, et cela est véridique.
And those blood vouchers
question,
from prisoners,
ces bordereaux,
are they still at S21 today,
ils sont toujours
as far
à
as you know?
Aujourd'hui, d'après ce que
or Toulsling.
Ils sont toujours à Toulsling?
Prakon.
Réponse.
The documents that were not shown me in the document remains a dual slang.
Thank you. I'd just like to refer you to some questions and answers that were given when Judge Laverne was asking you some questions.
And
you stated that Doig told you in training that it was an important rule that when torturing, you didn't torture, or the interrogators didn't torture prisoners to death, but they stopped short of that. You said that you saw other interrogators would torture detainees when they went unconscious anyway, in contravention to his rule. I'd like to show you a clip from the same video, Ricky Pan's S21 killing machine, and with your permission, Mr. President, it's clip number 11. It starts at the 9-second mark, and the same ERN number, and it's at 42 minutes, 58 seconds, to 43 minutes, and 29 seconds. With your permission.
The President, the AV officer, could you show the video clip as requested by the co-prosecutor on the screen? Prak Khan,
the
torturing at that time was cruel. I didn't think. I was arrogant. I had power over the enemy. I never thought of his life. I saw him as an animal. When I raised my hand, my heart never checked my brain, never stopped my hands from striking. My heart and my hand work together. Torture was like that.
C'était ça, la torture.
Mr. Prak Khan, when you started at S21, did you think of prisoners as animals when you first started, or was that something that developed over time as you worked there?
Qui a grandi en vous au fur et à mesure que vous y exerciez vos fonctions.
Prak Khan.
Réponse.
I would like to exercise my right to remain silent.
Le silence.
Thank you. Judge Laverne also asked you another question in relation to the interrogation of a female prisoner, and you testified that you interrogated
Nai Nan.
Now, I would like you to look at the following film clip, and I have a couple of questions to ask you. Mr. President, it's clip 20. It's the same video, Rithi Pan's killing machine. It's at 1 hour and 15 minutes and 13 seconds to 19 minutes and 30 seconds. And it's clip number 20, with your permission, Your Honour.
The President, the AV officer, could you please show the video clip as requested by the co-prosecutor on the screen? Prak Khan. Nai Nan was a medic at Hospital 98. I interrogated this young lady for 4 or 5 days without getting a thing out of her.
Elle disait qu'elle ne savait rien.
She said she knew nothing. I insisted, to what organization did she belong? What was her relationship with the head of the unit?
Mr. Prak Khan, the person that you see on that photograph there, is that Nai Nan, the person you interrogated?
Que vous aviez interrogé?
Prak Khan.
Réponse.
That is the real photo of Nai Nan.
C'est une photo authentique.
Thank you. If the video can continue, please.
Est-ce que l'on peut continuer la projection?
For 4 or 5 days, she refused to answer.
Alors j'ai demandé
so I asked Dutch and Jan what to do. They told me to use hot method to frighten her.
Pour lui faire peur. J'ai suivi leur conseil.
I took their advice. I insulted
je l'ai insulté,
her.
Je l'ai intimidé.
Intimidated her.
J'ai tapé du poing sur
pounded
la table.
On the table.
J'ai cassé
I broke off a tree branch and beat
battre.
Her. She pissed out of fear. When I hit her, she pissed herself.
Elle ne s'est pas contrôlée.
Then she asked
puis,
to make her confession.
Nine
nuns' confessions.
Je
I made her write it in 4 or 5 days. I got a page of it.
Reading it,
I didn't know what network was involved or what party. It contained nothing. So I explained and suggested how she write it using my method. She should describe a network, a party, an activity of sabotage, a network leader, and in the end, we managed to write up this document.
One night.
Here is the document. On the last page, here there's a signature. Prakon signature, your signature dated the 5th of January 1977. And here is the young woman's answer.
Hain
assigned me a mission to shit on the rice, the beans, next to the toilets, in buildings and houses, in order to ruin the reputation of the command post hospital, because it was a model hospital. And then Jane assigned me a mission to sit in the operating room. I don't understand.
Je ne comprends pas.
Did you believe that sabotage happened?
De sabotage pour vous, c'était croyable.
At that time, it was believable. When I saw sabotage, I believed it. When I interrogated her, I gave her three targets. One, CIA. Two, KGB. Three, the Dune enemy. And out of the three, she chose the CIA. So I then interrogated her along those lines, looking for her network, her chief, her accomplices, the sabotage activities at the hospital. That's why I could believe her. One night, I did not think the CIA committed such sabotage, and that woman was only 19 years old, according to her biography. Is this her handwriting? Prakon. That's my handwriting. She hadn't gone to school, and I couldn't read her writing. She made mistakes. So I wrote for her, corrected her, embellished it. One night. I don't understand your feelings you are bringing, no more than those of Dutch and Jant. How could you think it was true?
Prakon.
At that time, the aim was to indoctrinate us. We had to believe in sabotage activities or we couldn't arrest the enemy. When Dutch received the document, he made no comment. One night, he agreed.
Prakon.
Yes.
Mr. Prak Khan, you talked about
the President, the Defense Council is on his feet. You may proceed.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Juste une observation. Les co-procureurs ont dit qu'on ne voyait pas de témoins sur ce document. On en voit un que vous verrez prochainement devant la Chambre. Attention, Monsieur le co-procureur.
So please beware, Mr. Co-prosecutor. Perhaps it might have been a translation issue, Your Honor. I said there were no protected witnesses
on this public
video called S21, the killing machine. But there was no protected witnesses are on that, Your Honor.
Donc sur cette vidéo, il n'y avait pas de témoins
sort of slightly undermined, that comment slightly undermined the whole aspect of it, but
cette intervention,
perhaps if I can move on. Mr. Prak Khan,
la dynamique.
You talked about in that DVD, in that, that film clip, you talked about indoctrination to treat someone as an enemy. When you were at S21, who was responsible for indoctrinating you to treat prisoners as enemies?
Pour que vous appreniez à traiter les prisonniers comme des ennemis.
Prakon. At S21, it was only Dutch who indoctrinated our stance, our absolute stance against the enemy. And that we had to take it seriously and we had to consider the enemy as animals. So then we would be in the position to extract the confessions from the enemy.
As was explained in the video, would you ever think of behaving like that before you went to S21? Would that have been your normal behavior?
Pour vous un comportement normal?
Response. Could you please rephrase your question,
please? Pouvez-vous reposer votre question, s'il vous plaît?
Prior to starting work at S21, I assume you didn't treat people in that way as you described in the video. Is that correct? Is it only from being at S21 that you started to act in that manner?
Response. I would not want to respond to this question.
Mr. Prakkan, you worked at S21 for at least for over 2 years. You've given evidence that during that time the accused gave you political training sessions, gave you interrogation training sessions, gave you torture training sessions. He spoke to you over the telephone about torture. He made annotations about how to interrogate and how to torture. From all of your dealings with Doik whilst you're at S21, what type of person was he? What type of personality did he have? Was he lazy? Was he disciplined? Can you give us an idea of what you thought of his personality at that time?
Response. At that time was a studious person, enthusiastic in his work, and whatever he did, he was meticulously done it.
Mr. Prakkan, you said he was enthusiastic. You were at S21 until the end, until January 1979. Did you ever see that enthusiasm change?
Avez-vous vu cet enthousiasme faiblir?
Réponse. Through my observation, occasionally,
parce que j'ai pu observer parfois,
I had not noted any changes in his
je n'ai pas vraiment noté de changement dans l'enthousiasme dont il faisait montre.
Only when there was internal
ce n'est que
problems that
problems internes,
we worked harder and that everyone start to feel so afraid.
Que nous avons travaillé plus dur et que nous avons tous commencé à avoir peur.
Mr. President, I just have two last questions. Mr. Prakkan, in court today and yesterday, it seems to be difficult for you to admit your involvement in crimes at S21. And you've made a number of admissions of your involvement in crimes through a number of documentaries that are public documentaries. And there are at least four documentaries which you have been very explicit to your involvement in crimes at S21 and also the nature of the Khmer Rouge. And the documentaries are The Cambodia Report by Phil Rees, and that's D69 V0017 to 2527. And then Inside Pol Pot Secret Prison, D69 V0017 2525. And as stated, Rithi Pan's S21, The Killing Machine, and also The Land of Silence, D69-0017-2520. There are numerous accounts from you on camera talking about your involvement in crimes. My question is, why did you come forward? Why did you go public to your involvement in crimes at S21? Because I assume you were silent about it for a long time. Why did you decide to participate in these documentaries and stating your involvement in the crimes at S21? Can you help the court understand that?
En dire un peu plus à la chambre sur ce point.
Réponse. I thought it was my duty to do that.
Mon devoir de le faire.
That's why I had to reveal the truth.
Il fallait que je révèle la vérité.
Thank you, Your Honor. I have no further questions. Thank you, Mr. Prak.
Merci, Monsieur le Témoin.
The President, now it is time we give the opportunity to the civil party lawyers, and each group has 15 minutes. So we can now start from group 4 first. Please be reminded that you have 15 minutes to put questions to this witness. Hong Kong Soon, thank you, Mr. President. Your Honours. Good morning, Mr.
Prak.
I would like to put some questions to you. Yesterday, you talked about the time when you left Dual Slang prison, former S21 security office. A few days before that, you said that you did not work.
Avez-vous dit, on vous avait indiqué.
Is it fair to say that the reason you did not work a few days before the 7th of January because you were not assigned to do the task or because you got order not to perform your task anymore? Response. Yesterday I did say so because before the 7th of January, just a few days before that, there were transportation of detainees from the prison days and night and interrogation ground to a halt. And there was no more interrogation, and we were idle and just stayed in the houses because detainees were all smashed at Chuang Ek.
Hong Kong Soon, thank you.
Question. Through Merci. The photo shown by the co-prosecutor, you pointed to
Sur
the place where you had worked,
vous avez indiqué l'endroit où vous avez
on,
travaillé.
Located the house located on a small road.
vous travaillez,
and that Mr. François Roux would like that location to be marked as A, for example. So,
que cet endroit soit marqué par la lettre A.
From the place you worked and to the down part of that location, you said there were houses for interrogations. So the detainees would be taken to be interrogated in those houses, and that they were taken from Bonnier Yard High School, or the former compound of Aspen D1. Is that correct? Response. People who were taken out to be interrogated were taken from the inner buildings, and the interrogation were conducted from 7 to 11 a.m. And after the interrogation session, they would be returned to the cells, and then they would be taken out again to be interrogated for another session before they were return to the cell. So the detainees would not be kept in the interrogation houses after interrogation.
Hong Kong-soon,
thank you. When detainees were taken from the inner building, were you in charge of walking those detainees, or were you assigned to just wait to receive them at any particular point of location?
Response.
I walked to the outside of the building and asked the guards to just walk or to take out the detainees, and I was waiting outside. Hong Kong-soon, thank you. I would like to move back a little bit to the time when during the Liberation Day.
Au jour de la libération.
During the time that you did not work, a few days before that time, did you visit the workshop?
Vous êtes rendu à l'atelier.
Response.
Réponse.
At that time, we did not move about. I, of course, walked to the kitchen and then returned to the place where we had stayed. Hong Kong-soon, thank you. Could you please verify the term kitchen? I mean, kitchen here was located in the Tuol Slang compound, or where was it located? Response. The kitchen situated between Street 330 and the East Road, so it was located there.
Côté Est.
Hong Kong-soon. So
question.
That kitchen was meant to serve food for staff member or interrogators,
à savoir les interrogateurs,
or was it the same kitchen for the other detainees at S21?
Préparait à manger pour les détenus de S21.
Response. There was another kitchen to the west, which is separate from this kitchen, because that kitchen was for detainees, and this kitchen outside of the wall of the complex was for the staff members.
Au personnel.
Hong Kong-soon, thank you.
Question.
I am clear now.
Merci. Maintenant, je comprends mieux.
Regarding the interrogations,
concernant les interrogatoires,
if any detainee could not write,
ce qui se passait,
then
quand un
you would be of assistance to write those confessions. So in that kind of writing, were you supposed to write whatever you prefer rather than
cas,
whatever the detainee would tell
vous
you?
Vouliez-vous écrire, ou bien est-ce que vous écriviez sous la dictée du
response.
Détenu? Réponse.
Normally, we wrote according to what the detainees told. Sometimes we could not understand what they told us, so we asked them to repeat.
Alors,
and in writing, actually, we were not supposed to write our own ideas other than those of the detainees. Mr. Komsun, thank you. You said here that there were three options, the CIA, the KGB, and the Vietnamese enemies or spies. And then detainees would be put to select among the three. So to you, do you or had you ever understood those terms?
Est-ce que vous-même vous compreniez ces termes?
Response. I was not well explained, and detainees were not well explained either, because we just wanted them to say which string or network they belong to, you know, the KGB or CIA or Vietnamese enemies. Mr. Komsun, thank you. What about the detainees? Did they understand the three terms used here? Response. Sometimes detainees said they were associated with CIA, KGB, or Vietnamese enemies. So different detainees would give different accounts concerning the terms. Mr. Komsun, yesterday you indicated about the confessions which were adjusted before they were sent to
qui étaient retouchés superiors. Avant d'être soumis à vos supérieurs.
My question is, were the adjustments made si because interrogator would prefer the confessions to be like what they preferred, or what?
Les interrogateurs adaptaient les aveux en fonction de ce qu'ils attendaient.
The term adjustment here was meant,
il faut entendre,
in particular for example, the detainees would handwrite the documents, and then we would like to have them typed, and then we can also correct some words or structures so that they are easy to be read. Mr. Komsun, thank you. The same confessions. Yesterday, you already stated this, but we would like your clarification. During interrogations, there were whore Dutch who walked past and sometimes came into the interrogation session, and there were some annotations on documents. When you were interrogating the detainees, were they entering the interrogation room and then annotated on those pieces of documents? Respond, I think it was a different situation. This kind of things did not happen simultaneously, because after the confession sent to them, then they would annotate on the documents, but they only occasionally walked past the place where we interrogated the detainees. Mr. Hong Kong-soon, thank you. You said they walked past Deutsch and Paul. Were they just walked past, or were they also taken part in the interrogation?
Prenez part aux interrogatoires.
Response, I think it was none of their duty to interrogate detainees, but it was their duty to patrol the area.
Mais ils avaient parmi leurs tâches celle de
Mr. Hong Kong-soon,
de patrouiller.
Now, regarding the compound of the S21 or the former lycée Bonnyayat.
Je m'intéresserai maintenant à l'ancien lycée
Bonnyayat. Now, to the south of the complex,
au sud,
or the dual slang prison, were there any special prisons for special detainees?
D'autres prisons spéciales pour certains détenus.
Response. To the south of the complex, the next to the road, there was a special prison, the place I never went to.
C'est un endroit dans lequel je ne suis jamais entré.
Mr. Kumsun, thank you.
Question, merci.
Regarding your travel from your place to the place where you saw a child being dropped from upper floor. Could you tell the court about your freedom of moving about? So to what extent were you allowed to move about in that compound?
Response,
I was vested with the rights to only walk or move about from my place to the place where people were interrogated and to the kitchen. That's all.
J'avais aussi le droit d'aller à la cuisine, c'est tout.
Last question, Mr. Hong Kumsun says.
Voici ma dernière
during
question.
The training sessions on interrogations led by Dodge in the house located next to his house, during such sessions, were there any miming activities, for example, how people would play role in such torture techniques? Was there any incident like that in that session? Response. No, there wasn't.
Réponse,
actually,
non.
We were only told and we only dictated what was being told and taught. Mr. Hong Kumsun, thank you, Mr. Prakorn. I have no further questions for the time being.
Merci, Mr. Prakorn. Monsieur le Président, je n'ai pas d'autres questions à poser pour l'instant.
The President, next,
président.
Civil Party Lawyers Group 2, you take the floor.
Je vous en prie.
Sorry, say the President, Group 3, next.
Bonjour Monsieur le Président, bonjour Madame et Messieurs les juges, bonjour Monsieur Bracken. En fait, Monsieur le Président, j'aimerais que vous m'autorisiez, pendant le temps qui m'est accordé, à poser des questions prévenues sur le témoignage de Monsieur Bracken.
I would like to put the questions that I have planned for the testimony of Mr. Bracken, if the court will grant me leave to do so.
The President, could you please repeat your statement because I don't think I understand what you are saying.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Je vous demandais, Monsieur le Président, si vous m'autoriseriez, pendant les 15 minutes qui m'étaient accordées, à poser des questions aux prévenus sur le témoignage de Monsieur Prakan.
To the detainee, to the accused, about Mr. Prakan instead.
The President, you are granted the leave to do so, but
oui,
we would like
je vous
to
à le faire, mais
also inform you that since during the session when the testimony of Prakorn is being heard, then you should put questions to the witness. But questions are welcome to be put to the accused, but only if the questions are related to the testimony of the witness here before the court. The accused, please be ready to respond to the civil party lawyer questions.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Ms.
Bonjour,
Jacquin.
Monsieur.
Thank you, Mr.
Je me présente. Je suis Martine Jacquin. Je suis avocat du groupe des parties civiles numéro 3. J'aimerais, Monsieur, que vous nous disiez si vous confirmez ou si vous infirmez les déclarations du témoin lorsqu'il dit que vous assuriez les cours pour les interrogateurs et que également vous assuriez la formation sur les méthodes de torture.
The training for methods of torture as well.
The accused.
L'accusé.
Prak Khan The outset was the staff of the special unit. Later on, he was put into the interrogation group. So my education to him regarding interrogations ended. And Prakhan also acknowledged that when he started interrogating detainees, he was not given any instruction. He only observed other interrogators during the interrogation sessions. Later on, he attended trainings with the other interrogators, and you can find this reference in Brother Mom Nai's document. So these documents can be found with the document of Brother Chan.
On trouve ces réponses dans les
However,
documents, les déclarations faites par Chan.
I would like to also emphasize that he worked as the interrogator in early 1977 after he left the special unit. First, he was not trained, but later on he learned how to conduct interrogation. However, the four methods of interrogations were not taught to him, and he did not learn this. And I already stated earlier, even during the interrogation investigation phase, about this, and it made it clear that already.
Merci, monsieur. Je sais
que vous avez déjà dit un certain nombre de choses, mais je crois qu'il est intéressant d'avoir vos observations directement sur le témoignage de monsieur Prakhan. La deuxième question que je voudrais vous poser concerne l'incident avec l'enfant qui a été jeté du balcon, qui a été évoqué plusieurs fois. Est-ce que vous pensez que cet incident est vrai ou qu'il a pu réellement exister? Et est-ce que c'était une méthode qui pouvait être acceptée pour tuer un enfant ou impressionner sa mère pour la faire parler?
Acceptable method of killing a child so that his or her mother could be forced to testify or to confess?
The accused, thank you, the lawyer. I have been expecting to respond to this question long ago, and thank you for putting it before me, and I would like to respond as follows. I don't believe it.
Je ne crois pas.
It's short. My observation is that there were no three-story building located at that location. At the beginning, I read Prakhan's confession or testimony. I thought that he was mentioning about the building in the compound of Bonnyard High School. But then he stated that the location was outside, so I am not convinced at all that there was such building outside the compound.
Merci, monsieur. Également, il a été plusieurs fois évoqué par le témoin le fait que vous passiez un moment durant les interrogatoires et que parfois vous vous interrogiez un moment également avant de repartir. Est-ce que vous confirmez ou est-ce que vous affirmez ces déclarations?
Do you confirm or deny the witness's testimony?
The accused. I was in the leadership of S21. My duty was to annotate on the confessions
les aveux
of the victims
qui étaient faits par les détenus.
During my whole life, since I started to become the chairman of S21, I only interrogated one detainee, and only one. I interrogated Koytun, and that's all.
C'est tout.
Mais monsieur, quand on est directeur, parfois on fait le tour de l'établissement pour voir si chacun travaille bien correctement. C'était dans ce contexte-là que vous auriez pu passer, comme le disait Prakan, durant l'interrogatoire.
You may have stepped in for a few minutes during the interrogation. Is it not possible?
The accused. Your question is based on the very good observation.
Oui,
I really appreciate it.
Justifiée.
I would like to also indicate that S21 prison Bing was in charge of his
Bing
respective unit.
Qui s'occupait de cela.
Sometimes Paul would be in charge.
Ou parfois Paul.
Regarding the interrogation sessions, there were the heads of the teams.
C'était eux qui étaient les chefs d'équipe.
For example, Prakon's group, there was Tit, who was the team leader. Whatever happened during that time, Prakon had to report to him.
Prakon faisait rapport à Tit.
He could not pass through his team leader straight to me. It was also possible that Mom Nai could be used.
Mom Nai s'occupe de cela.
But more frequently, Comrade Ho would be called to assist me regarding this matter. And I would like to take this opportunity to also make it clear that I really respected the organization, the assignments,
l'organisation et les affectations.
If I assigned them as my deputy, then I had to build trust on them and to respect their performance.
Et je respectais ce qu'ils faisaient.
If I assigned them as the chief of the interrogators, then they would be expected to be assigned to monitor those interrogators.
Les interrogatoires.
If I discussed any matter with Prakon without going through them, what was the point of assigning them to be the leaders of the group?
À désigner des adjoints et des chefs d'équipe.
So they were accountable for me, and they had to report everything to me. Whatever committed wrong, then they had to be accountable for their acts before me. So that's all.
Me rendait compte de ce qui se passait dans la prison.
Merci, monsieur, pour ces précisions. Également, confirmeriez-vous ou infirmeriez-vous le fait que vous donniez à un interrogateur, avant qu'il interroge, des éléments sur le contexte, sur la situation de la personne qu'il allait interroger pour l'aider à rechercher les éléments que vous recherchez?
In order to bring together these elements that you were looking for.
Prakon, counsel. I listened to your words in French.
J'ai écouté votre question en français.
I still do not understand it clearly.
Je
can
ne
you
comprends pas
restate your question again?
Comme ça me dit, madame.
I would like to say again,
je voudrais
said the accused.
Redire.
I still do not understand the difference between affirmer and confirmer. Can you explain a little bit further?
Complètement confirmer la différence entre affirmer et confirmer.
Monsieur, confirmer, c'est dire que le témoin a dit quelque chose de vrai, et affirmer, c'est dire que le témoin a dit quelque chose qui n'est peut-être pas vraiment exact.
something that is maybe
ce que je demandais,
exactly
c'est
true.
Si so what Prakan asking, a dit plusieurs fois qu'il avait des directives avant les interrogatoires, orales ou écrites. Et donc, je voulais savoir si vous étiez d'accord sur ce point de vue-là ou pas.
So I wanted to know whether you agreed with that or not, whether you agreed that he was receiving these instructions.
I did not have time.
Je n'avais pas le temps
to provide instructions to every single interrogator,
à chaque interrogateur,
including Prakon,
y compris Prakon.
Even the expert
même
staff of mine, that is,
pour
Kamrad Pon,
mon personnel expert, le camarade Pon, par exemple.
I did not have sufficient time to give him instructions on every single aspect of the matters.
Sur chaque aspect, chaque interrogatoire.
Enfin, monsieur, deux dernières questions. La première, est-ce que vous diriez que les prises de sang, les prélèvements de sang ont été faits sans votre accord?
L'accusé.
I would like to explain the matter in two sections.
Expliquer ceci en deux parties.
In his statement, Prakon said
déposition,
the drawing of blood was done on 1,000
persons,
or even more than 1,000.
Ou même plus.
He said every week 20 people had their blood drawn.
Se voyait saigner.
I calculated the number and I concluded that
dont je tire la conclusion.
Prakon actually calculated the number 20 times 52 weeks equaled 1 year.
20 fois 52 semaines sur un an, donc.
Therefore, it adds up to
cela donne un total
approximately 1,000. And when I see this figure, it reminded me of the
chiffre,
witness KW30.
Le témoin KW30
that witnessed for M13.
Témoin pour M13.
Said every day M13 executed 20 prisoners.
Exécutait 20 prisonniers.
Therefore, within the 3 year period, or a little bit over 3 years period, M13 executed more than 30,000 people.
Plus de 30,000 personnes exécutées au total à M13.
So there is the similarity
donc,
between these
vous voyez
two
qu'il y a un
witnesses.
Parallèle entre ces deux témoins.
Yesterday, Prakon,
hier,
before
Prakon,
this chamber,
devant cette chambre,
did not dare to confirm
osé confirmer
that the blood was drawn from more than 1,000 people.
Était prélevé sur plus de 1,000 personnes.
I would like to say that the documents from those people whose blood was drawn still remain.
Concernant les personnes dont le sang a été prélevé, ces documents restent toujours.
From my calculation,
et d'après mon calcul,
there were probably 100 or so people
environ une centaine
whose blood
de
was drawn.
Dont
and on the second point,
et deuxième partie,
the person who ordered
la personne
the blood to be drawn was my superior.
Commandait ces prises de sang, c'était mon supérieur.
That is Son Sen.
À savoir Son Sen.
And on the third point.
Et troisièmement.
I categorically denied the testimony of this Prakorn.
Témoignage de Prakorn.
Who yesterday said that I provided the blood to three hospitals.
Je fournissais le sang à trois hôpitaux.
I only provided the blood
Je
to one hospital, that is the hospital of the general staff.
L'hôpital de l'état-major.
I did not have any contact
Je
with
aucun
hospital
contact avec
17.
L'hôpital 17.
The hospital 17
l'hôpital
was a civilian hospital.
Était un hôpital pour civils.
It did not provide treatments to
Il
soldiers.
Il ne fournissait pas de traitement aux soldats.
And the chief of the general staff
Et
or the general staff did not have any contact with the civilian hospitals at all.
Avec les hôpitaux civils.
Furthermore,
De
the 703 Division Hospital, as stated by Prakorn yesterday,
selon les dires de Prakorn hier,
was at the Monivong Hospital, as he said,
fait,
and this is a lie.
C'est ce qu'il a dit. Or, c'est un mensonge.
The 703 Division
La
Hospital was originally at the Monivong Hospital.
Hôpital à l'hôpital Monivong.
But in 1978,
en général,
it relocated
en 1978,
to
Nha Lương. Cela a été déménagé à Nha Lương.
And
Et
my superior
mon
worked
supérieur
there at that location.
Y a travaillé.
And my younger sibling
Et
also worked in that hospital. My younger sister.
Une jeune sœur à moi a aussi travaillé à cet hôpital.
Therefore, his statement that I
Par
provided the blood to
l'énoncé selon lequel je
hospital
fournissais
98,
du sang à
hospital
l'hôpital 98, à l'hôpital 703,
and hospital 17.
17
It's a fabrication.
Cela
I only acknowledge one hospital where I sent the blood to.
Auquel effectivement je faisais fournir le sang.
And I denied the blood
Et
to be supplied to the other two
je
hospitals.
Je refuse l'énoncé selon lequel les autres hôpitaux étaient fournis par mes soins.
This is my response,
voilà
and
ma
I
réponse.
Thank you very much, Council.
Merci.
The
President, your group has
Le
actually
votre
5 minutes overtime.
A en fait excédé son temps de parole de
And
5
now
minutes.
It's time for the break, so the
Il
chamber will take a 20 minutes break.
Temps de faire une pause, 15 minutes.
Until 5 through 11 when
Jusqu'à
it resumes.
Moins 5, nous reprendrons donc l'audience à 11h moins 5.
Court officer, can you provide Monsieur necessary refreshments to the witness? And bring him back before 5 to 11.
Et
the hearing is adjourned.
Le ramener pour 11h moins 5.